Let's talk about judging. Well, most of us knows that it's wrong to judge others. Yet, let's admit it, we are all judgmental in nature. And most of us strive to be better people, better versions of ourselves, and strive not to judge others. While, of course, it's okay to judge unethical and dangerous and unfair actions of ourselves and others, we really do need to make conscious, continuous conscious effort to refrain from judging other people, especially for their traits that they have not even chosen, such as their appearance or their level of intelligence, you know, calling people stupid, for example. Let me tell you, when I was young, throughout my childhood and my youth, I felt very superior because I was consistently told that I was superiorly intelligent, and I was really proud of it. And it took me a while to mature, because even though I am intelligent, but really I was very immature. When I matured, I realized how foolish of me to feel so proud and feel superior about that, because I didn't even earn that. It's nothing to be proud of, because it's nothing that I achieved or I earned. It was just given to me for whatever reason, just like certain looks are given to certain people. But even that, I mean, there are so many different forms of intelligence. Like, for example, I never knew when I was young, how to listen to my body. I was so detached from it. So I definitely severely lacked that kind of intelligence, right? Knowing how to listen to your body, how to give it a rest when it needs to, for example, is a form of intelligence, right? Or how to protect yourself is a form of intelligence. And when I finally realized how wrong, how foolish of me it was to feel superior, which was a judgment, in a way, of me and of others as inferior to me, I realized that actually another thing about myself, and that is that so-called superiority of mine was nothing but an overcompensation for the deeply buried down a severe sense of incompetence and inferiority. And that's much more damaging and serious. I had a sense of inferiority and incompetence and wrongness about who I was, who I am in essence, which was installed into me by my environment in combination with my sensitivity, you know, just and by loving great parents and aunts and uncles and surrounding, because I was either labeled as too curious or too lively or too sensitive. All of those twos led me to believe that something was wrong with me. So I latched on to one thing that I was good at, you know, this academic intelligence, and really kind of developed that, put all my effort into that, unconscious and conscious. So you see, it really is wrong to judge people about their traits. Yes, let's hold ourselves and others accountable for actions that are not aligned with our hearts, that are not kind. But let's not judge ourselves or others. And you know, I realized from my own experience that judging oneself as superior is equally wrong and unhealthy and damaging as judging oneself as inferior. It's equally damaging for our hearts and our souls. So let's all be inviting, inclusive, tolerant, and kind of towards each other. And that's especially important now in these weird times when the world seems to be more than ever, at least that I know, divided in these two large groups with two diametrically opposing opinions about what's going on with the virus. Well, everyone is entitled to their opinion, and let's just respect that and hear each other. And if we don't want to hear it, we don't need to, but we don't have to attack either. Okay, let's love each other. That's all.